Hello guys, my name is Lelia Duke. I'm going to very briefly tell you about my journey and my experience with the TR and essential oils. In 2013, my daughter Riley, she's my oldest daughter, at the time she was 6 years old, and she was clinically diagnosed with ADHD. And I knew at that time that I did not want to put her on medication. Not that I'm against it, I just knew at this time in her life, I wanted to explore other options. At that time, my good friend, Tracy Bonham, she loves to research, and she's like a research guru, and she had read some blogs about essential oils and using them for ADHD, so I thought I would give it a shot, and I did. Up until that time, I had no idea what essential oils were. None. I mean, I thought they were just fragrances, which they are, but I had no idea the healing power that was in essential oils. One thing I did know is that the supplement that my daughter was on was over $100 a month. So bringing in the essential oils was a no-brainer. They would be beneficial for the whole family. And also today, they have opened up an opportunity for my family financially for me to stay home full-time. And also on my team, I have a few other that are coming home full-time. And how exciting is that, that this company gives us the opportunity financially to do what's in our heart to do. You know, it's a vehicle for our dreams. I enrolled with doTERRA in April of 2013, and I quickly started to become familiar with the oils. I became addicted like so many of us are here today. I had tons of opportunities to use them on myself and my family, and I quickly discovered how they can replace everything in our medical cabinet, and that was exactly what I was looking for my family. I was not interested at all about the business plan. Honestly, I had no idea that it was a network marketing company. I just thought it was a company that Tracy introduced me to online, and I just ordered. And if I had known it was a business opportunity, I wouldn't have given it a thought, because at the time I was still working part-time and doing some other type of things. My plate was already full. So to entertain the thought of doing this as a business, I was not interested at all. I would casually share with my friends the first 8 months, just of our experiences, how they have helped us. And so I would have enrollments, and because I love the oils so much, I was ordering a lot every month. But I promised myself, if I'm gonna invest, I'm gonna use, and I did. So I decided that I would have my first class in December, so I enrolled in April, I had my first class in December. Lacey Graham taught it for me. Some of my other good friends were also enrolled at the same time, so we said, hey, let's just have a team class. And we did. The class was awesome. It's one of those classes that will go down in the books. We had people buying home essential kits like they were selling out. Now, I will tell you that happened again. So that was December of 2013. And that night, it really sparked a fire in a lot of our friends. And we said, you know what? We're going to give this business thing a shot. And I'm so glad that we did. So in January of 2014, I taught my first class. And just like today, I was nervous. And I prayed, and I didn't want to do it, but I did it anyways. And Angela Moran was kind enough to open up her house. We had a record-breaking attendance of over 30 people, and I stood there teaching the class, nervous as a wreck, but I survived, and I continued. I continued to teach a class every month. I offered team classes for my team, and I would do that as well. Soon after Riley's diagnosis with ADHD, something started stirring in me. Maybe I'm so glad you're right. I did not want to be the only one. Something started stirring in me. And maybe you know, I fought this, and I said, no, I'm not going to do it. So after a lot of prayer, I decided that I was going to go to school with Riley, my daughter that was diagnosed. And it was a really good decision to pull her out of the school, because you see, the school that she got into, there were 35 spots and 1,200 applicants. She was chosen. Not only that, but we packed up and we moved a big 35 minutes away from our family and friends, which is a big deal when you're from a small town and you live there for 30 plus years. So when that started stirring in my heart, and I felt that's a prayer, I said, okay, help me do it. Now for me, I was like, well, we're just going to have to make a way. And this is what you've called us to do. And I truly believe in this. You're going to have to make a way. please take him full time. Because it was impossible. My husband was a fireman, and you know, as my teachers, they don't make a lot of money. So God had to show up, and he did. He answered those prayers, and he answered them through their tears. And my success has been quite amazing. It's not typical. I have an awesome upline to thank for some of it, but honestly, I can't take the credit. The credit goes to God. The credit goes to the Lord. Just to give you some stats, I hit silver. Once I started building in January, I hit silver in 3 months, gold in 11 months, and diamond in 15, which is crazy. Tired in February, and now I'm on full time. I'm just so thankful for the opportunity to get. I'm just so thankful to see my friends also who are just diving in and discovering what their why is and giving this business opportunity a shot. So, now that I'm past that, I want to tell you a little bit on how I did it. And like I said, I can't take the credit for it. But I had to be consistent with what needed to be done to reach my goals. So if you have, I did not do a PowerPoint, sorry. But if you go ahead and write this down, number one, I had a why. You need to have a why. My why was to be able to stay home full time and homeschool my children. This why is what kept me going, even when I did not see any fruit in my labor. And there was a lot of labor. You know, most of us give out at Elite. So, you know, when I was there for a little while, and I remember driving home thinking, you know, I'm not seeing the fruit in all this work I'm doing. But my why is what kept me going. Number two, set goals. Set realistic goals and set unrealistic goals. Write them out and keep them in front of you. Number three is I plan advance to help me reach my goals and also the goals of my team members. You know, I don't like talking in front of people. I'm very emotional, like Amy, and I just can't help it. My one prayer today was, Lord, help me not to cry, and it didn't happen. But I had to get out of my comfort zone, and you will too. And I had to do what it took to make my why happen. And I want you to know that I did every class afraid. I'm standing here today afraid. But if you just plan the events, you will have to prepare yourself. And you will have to get ready. It forces you to do it. So I encourage each and every one of you to set up those classes and team events. Number four, you need to have belief. You need to believe in yourself. You can do this. You need to believe in your why. It is worth fighting for. You also need to have a belief in the product. You cannot be passionate about something that you don't believe in. You need to use and have personal testimonies about the goal. And you also need to have a belief in doTERRA as a company. They are a great company to work for and support. Number five, lastly, you need to have commitment. You have to put in the energy to see the results. And it's gonna take a year to get your bearings on the business, as it would with any job or business. It's gonna take a year. So just know that going into it. And I want to encourage you to commit to doTERRA and building your business for at least 5 years. And I can almost promise you that if you use the tools that we have given you here today, that at the end of 5 years, you will be successful. So I want to leave you with this thought. It's not about finding the right person for your team, as it is becoming the right person for your team. Faith it until you become it, and be the diamond for your team. Thank you.